Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel TTS Food Tips. Today's recipe is an authentic Kerala-like cuisine commonly had during the rainy season when fishermen cannot go out to the sea. This is the dried prawns chutney or the dried prawns chamandi. Before starting today's video, I just want to share some videos and photos which we had taken during a short trip we had after being at home for 1.5 years. Felt really blessed that we could enjoy God's creation in such close proximity. The following are the videos of some reptiles and beautiful birds which we had close encounter with. This is a garden lizard which we found on our window. This is a sand bird which was sitting on the window to escape the rains. This is a red-tailed bulbul. These are a flock of quails enjoying nibbling at the grass. This is the small minivet. These birds are called punia. This is a rat snake that happened to enter our compound, probably searching for frogs which are in plenty due to the rain. Watch carefully and you can see a frog jumping. Here you can see a red crab walking on the parapet. Hope I could capture and share the blissfulness of God's creation, which we generally miss out in a busy city life. So now coming back to the recipe, in the state of Kerala, dried fish or prawns is a staple during rainy season, as fresh fish is hard to get. If you are new to my channel and this is your first visit, hello and welcome. I do post simple and interesting recipes every week. If you find my videos interesting, please do subscribe and join me in my journey. As this video was made during my trip and I didn't have any weighing scales, I have just given rough measurements. I have discarded the head of the prawns as my husband is allergic to it. Dry roast the prawns very well. In the same pan, dry roast the coconut and then the dried red chilies. Once roasted, keep all this aside. I have also taken a small onion, some curry leaves, some garlic cloves and a small piece of ginger. As my mixie was spoiled, I resorted to the old traditional way of grinding on a grinding stone. Add a little bit of salt to the chilies and grind that first. Let me tell you that this can be easily put into a mixie and ground within minutes. But grinding on a stone requires some time as well as muscle power. The taste and flavor that you get from a grinding stone or silbata can never be compared to that which is ground in a mixie. Add in the garlic and ginger first and then the onions and the curry leaves. I always enjoyed grinding on this stone but never found time when I was working. Now add in the coconut and grind it well. Finally, add in the prawns. We roast the prawns so that when grinding it is powdered well. Now add in the salt and tamarind paste. Also, as I found it less spicy, I had to resort to chili powder as I ran short of dried red chilies. Mix well and grind one last time to combine everything together. We haven't used any water for grinding. The dried prawns or shrimp gives a umami flavor to this chutney or chamandi. It's hard to resist another spoonful of this spicy and sour deliciousness. This is best had with steamed rice and sometimes even with dosa. The best part of grinding on the stone is yet to come. Do not wash the stone immediately after removing the chutney. Rub some rice onto the stone to get in all the remaining flavors that is left on it. You may have to add a pinch of salt to the rice, but the taste is so divine and heavenly that you will enjoy it to the maximum. This chutney will not last long, but if required, it can be stored in the fridge for 7 to 10 days. If you want to store it for a few months, then just grind together the roasted ingredients. If you enjoy watching my videos and find them helpful, please do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for new notifications. Also, do share them with your family and friends. Thank you for watching and meet you soon in my next one.